God. Crush them, Yadam, crush them, Brad. A kalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalal
people, welcome to the Crush Yard News Report. And you can see Popcorn and Bears are gonna chill in the video, right? Now, why them a chill? Them have a new song out under VP Records label. So it out, people, it out. It's a nice little tune. And it's long time, you know, see, an old veteran I mixed with one of the young star them on a track. And them have the nice melody where you can just roll a vibe to. Now, the song name God is Love, and you don't know Popcorn is a very godly person from a long time, cause you don't know say Mother Miss Rona Graham, right? But the collab is a real good look for the dancehall reggae fraternity, so you can just go and check it out. But we'll just leave the iTunes link so you can just go buy the tune there, right? It's at the end of the description. You can go out and go buy it. Spend your money, support dancehall, support reggae music. And we're gonna just leave it, we're gonna just leave it right now the clip now so you can just hear what I go on for the track. God is Love it name. Alright, Popcorn.
Salute, you know, to a living legend. Salute. Love. Run it.
All I know is God is holy. Protect your life, it's a one and only. Evil people will kill you slowly. All I know is God is holy. Protect your life.
So moving on real quick, I didn't get to access the original post, but I see this post from TVJ that Dr. Tuffan said that protocols were breached at the National Chest Hospital. Now, I actually took some time to do some research into that and see what really happened. But what happened is that, you know, people actually signed up or didn't sign up, and the mix up of the amount that was supposed to be there. There was some sort of mix up along the way, and then they had more than enough vaccine there. So some persons who were not scheduled actually just walk in and will get it, because it would have spoiled anyway. So persons kind of blew it a little bit out of proportion, but I understand where it is coming from. But you know, sometimes people always just try to twist the thing sometimes, so I understand where that is coming from. So I don't know is who trouble Bojo, but you don't know say Bojo Banton has been very vocal on the government's COVID-19 plan, taking the vaccine, the mask, the whole works. So you know, throughout the whole of that, the government has been ignoring him for some extent. But right now, I don't know who released this video of Bojo, but because it's not on his personal Instagram, so it's all over social media though. But here Bojo have to say for the government.
Good morning, Jamaica, and good morning to the world. All the while, I'm telling you, say, today for me, tomorrow for you, and I laugh. For everyone, I see a post out here, and I go and like, say, I ridicule me for the Jamaican when I talk out for them, and I talk out for y'all, how they can't talk for themselves, because I know fun lock up behind closed door, and because I'm so rich, and someone have so much nice friends. I know how to feel inside, but I can't say because I don't want to offend anybody. We don't have to offend anybody, we can't tell it to you like it is. Bridges of the Disaster, Risk Management Act, 10,000 and 30 days in prison. The government of Jamaica only going to 10,000 one time. And himself on a breach of disaster management act, he's going to fine for $10,000 or 30 days in prison. That is oppression and tyranny. Resisting arrest, 2,000 or 10 days in prison. Oppression and tyranny. I don't think the law enforcement of Jamaica, Jamaican people friend. On our citizen, on our own brother, on our own uncle, on our own father, and take this job to protect and serve Jamaica, but to not protect and serve politician and political interests. Right? When since we cannot speak out against the way we feel without risk of you pressuring we. Now, the Jamaican Constitution does not allow the government of Jamaica to use the office of the Prime Minister or any other office to oppress and pressure any citizen. Any citizen at all. You Jamaicans better wake up before them come kick off on the door 1-1 and do like what you see them do all over the place. Let me continue. So what can I hear there? Indecent language. 1,000 or 10 days in prison. And them come again and say additional fine of 10,000 or 10 days in prison. To a sergeant police officer. But me notice a trend. Me notice everybody who come out in a Jamaican vent the way them feel. Either the Jamaican populace come down upon them like we're supposed to be sheep. We're supposed to. So if the Prime Minister, everybody say we must go near shit, we're supposed to go up there and line up and eat it. Hold on, people. Hold on. Put on your thinking caps. And all the way are fooling them. Not because you go you where you go to some place make you smarter than we know. No guy can't tell you how to live. I'm not coming with a bag of bullshit like you say, hold on, we are fool. Remember, are we voting in? Who's supposed to run the country for we? Don't go like you don't want to switch it on me. Can't you be switch it on Jamaican people, let me know. And have the people them thinking that they work for politicians. No! Politicians work for the country as fiduciaries of this great corporation to ensure that they do the job of the office that they are elected to do. Do not use the office of the Prime Minister or the office of whichever politician it is to pressure the citizens. You are creating tyranny. You are tyrannical. I'm a thief too. Can enough money I get them along with Jamaican people now. You think the 10,000 can feed Jamaican people and lock up the whole island? Everybody lock down on the house and nobody don't want to talk because they're my own friend. Me no want no friend, I don't want no friend, I want to free the people. I'm with the people that live and stop this tyranny we're dealing with. We're pushing Jamaica people to the brink. And nobody don't want to tell them because they're afraid. I don't know why, because I don't have the dead squad them around there. We're just afraid for dead, they've been killing us. We're murder we, we're torture we, and we're rob we. So what more we can do to it? No, we're not going to try to make it extinct. It's crazy. Free the people and I'm going to use some common sense. I mean, stop being so damn reactive. Everybody just reactive. Why? I want to tell people about shot and none of them are taking a shot. I want to try fool boy. Here we go on. We want to see who take what who try to give my people them for take. Because when the people of Jamaica start dead, they can't tell them nothing, you know. They can't tell me nothing when Jamaican people start dead. Think about that.
All right, so last but by no means the least, guys. So Tootsie Birds, who sadly passed away last year in the year 2020, actually won his second Grammy. And his daughter came on Instagram and she gave a nice, heartfelt, touching message. And we're going to get into that message right now.
This is so bittersweet right now. My father, Frederick Hibbert, was a phenomenal gift to this world. On behalf of my mother, Mrs. Doreen Hibbert, and the rest of the family, I want to say thank you to his fans, to members of the band, to Zach and Shush, Chosen Jamaica, Sly Dunbar, Cyril Neville, Cameron Husty, Joe Murray, Eric Gardner, Hartwig and everyone at BMG Rights, Eric, Adam, Rob and Larry at Primary Wave, Justin Hill at UTA. Daddy, we love and we miss you. Thank you, everyone.
All right, thank you guys so much for watching all the way to the end. This has been another Crush Yard News Report. Now remember to like, share, definitely subscribe and hit the notification bell and keep up with the Crush Yard family. Just log on. Remember to follow us on Instagram @CrushYard and see you on the next video. All right, we out.